Welcome to Vacuum Wars, and to another episode in our series where we test some of the newer technologies that are rolling out on modern robot vacuums. Today, we're taking an in-depth look at mop washing docks and the water temperatures that companies claim are getting higher and higher. But we know that manufacturer claims, which may be true in a controlled lab setting, don't always work out that way in real-world environments. So we tested the docks for ourselves to see how their temperatures compared to the official numbers, and we learned which robot dock had the actual hottest temperatures in a side-by-side comparison. First off, let's do a quick overview about dock temperatures and why they matter. In the earlier days of mop washing docks, the mops were washed by water that was whatever the ambient temperature happened to be. The pads would be rinsed with room temperature water and agitated by a paddle or a squeegee to scrub off dirt and grime. Soon, multifunctional docks started introducing hotter and hotter water temperature claims, and now, some models, like the Dreamy Aqua 10 Roller, claim that their mop washing water can reach boiling temperatures. We started our test by compiling the officially stated mop washing temperatures from the major brands, focusing for this test on whatever model had the highest temperature rating within a brand's lineup. These top temperatures ranged from the Ecovax X11 with a high temp of 167 degrees Fahrenheit, which is 75 degrees Celsius, all the way to the Dreamy Aqua 10 at 212 degrees Fahrenheit. After we identified a brand's highest temperature dock, we put it to the test and compared the results side by side with the docks from the other brands. For each dock, we used a laser thermometer and took three readings immediately after each mop washing cycle. We repeated this entire test twice for consistency. We also ran a third test for each dock where we interrupted the wash cycle mid-clean to measure the temperature of the wash water before it drained, in case there was a difference. Then, we added a 7.1 degree Fahrenheit calibration offset to all our readings. The results were pretty surprising. After calculating the averages and adjusting for the offset, the Roborock Saros Z70 had the highest actual temperature reading in our tests, even though it didn't have the highest official number. Funny enough, the Ecovax X11, which had the lowest official rating among the robots we tested, beat most of the other robots to stand in second place. The dock that had the highest temperature claim, the Dreamy Aqua 10, came in third place in actual temperature, tying with the new Shark Power Detect Thermocharged. The surprising loser was the Muva Z60 Ultra, which trailed significantly behind the others in our test, even though its official temperature matched the Roborock's. In fact, with the exception of the Muva, most of the docks did tend to have very close actual temperatures, within a few degrees of each other, despite having a wide range of official numbers. This was an important reminder that official specs don't always match real performance. We will continue adding to our testing protocol to keep up with the changing technologies of robot vacuums, which are developing quickly as brands race to solve common robot vacuum limitations. You can see our favorite robot vacuums and robot vacuum and mop combos on our top 20 robot vacuum list, which we update regularly to reflect our most recent testing results. We purchase and test all of the robots ourselves, so you know you're always getting our honest take based on our independent test results. Don't forget to subscribe to Vacuum Wars before you go. Thanks for watching.